Hey guys, my name is Robert. For the longest time, I was absolutely happy with my Magic Mouse. Paired with BetterTouchTool, which I was using to add lots of actions to different gestures, I felt it was just all that I ever needed. But after more than a decade with this mouse, it started having some battery issues and I thought that it was time for a change. If you have ever done some research looking for a new mouse, you probably saw a lot of videos talking about the Logitech MX Master series. This is considered one of the top productivity devices by many users. This is, of course, totally subjective, and I'm not here to talk about the ergonomics or features that you probably already saw in so many other videos. Instead, I want to share something different. How to make your mouse truly powerful with some amazing tools that most people don't talk about. A lot of what I will cover here is not specific to this mouse, so even if you have something else, I am sure that you will find something useful here. Let me get something out of the way. You might be wondering, why not just use the default Logitech software for your mouse? There's a lot of information about this online. You can do a quick Google search, but basically, it has too much bloat. It is a very heavy application with high CPU usage. It's constantly making internet requests to unknown destinations, which shouldn't be necessary for this kind of app. It's also a nightmare to uninstall because it places files everywhere. So I'll be explaining not only how to replicate the functionality of the default Logitech app, but actually improve it and do so much more. I'll talk to you about several different applications that, even when working with one another, are much lighter, more trustworthy, and offer so much more customization. By the way, if you use Magic Mouse and Trackpad only, maybe, just maybe, all that you need is BetterTouchTool. For Magic Mouse gestures, I don't think there's anything quite like it. You can still stick around to learn about my setup, but with BetterTouchTool alone, you will have already plenty of customization to be busy with. Now, for everyone else, while many apps can improve scrolling and add small features to your mouse, BetterMouse and SteerMouse are probably the most popular and powerful options if you want to make the most of all your device buttons. To tell you the truth, both applications are very, very good, and I do not plan to dive deep into all the different features. Here I'm on the website of SteerMouse, and I actually do not have this one installed anymore, but the interface looks like this, and with BetterMouse, we got a menu bar application that, in my opinion, feels a little bit more modern. We have different options for the scroll wheel. We have all the different buttons and actions that we can assign. And here we have some of the actions like zoom, jumping between tracks, making your system sleep or log out. All of these actions honestly are not that many compared to some of the other automation applications that I will be showing you later. But we have the ability to also assign keyboard shortcuts, which opens so many other possibilities that I will also cover in a little bit. Now, I want to tell you what made me choose BetterMouse on top of SteerMouse. And let me go to this other screen, and this is my mouse. With this mouse, we got the left button, the right button, the middle click, we have this other button, we have the thumb button, and we got these two. To all of these, you can assign different actions when you press and release or when you press and hold. You can even press, hold, and then scroll to the top, scroll to the bottom for different actions. But with BetterMouse, and this is something that you do not have with SteerMouse, you can press and hold one of the recognized buttons and at the same time drag the mouse to the front or drag the mouse to the back, or drag it to one side, to the other one, and you can assign different actions to that. In this way, you have some gestures that feel very, very natural. So it's just very nice to be able to swipe between different workspaces, for example. Or if I'm on my browser, I can press a button and then swipe up to open a new tab. If I'm on my note-taking app, again, I can press a button and swipe up to open a note. I can swipe down to close a window, stuff like that. It just feels very, very Apple-like gestures. Another thing that BetterMouse has that I couldn't find in SteerMouse is that BetterMouse has this, let me see. In the thumb wheel, you have a two-finger scroll. And what this is doing is simulating the gesture that you have with two fingers on your trackpad. And this is useful for some native applications in Apple because, for example, in Bear that I use for note taking, I can use that gesture to hide or show my sidebar. In my browser, I can also go to the previous page or to the next page. So It's just little details. And another thing that I also found in BetterMouse that I couldn't find in SteerMouse was that we got all those buttons that I was telling you about, but we also got the thumb wheel. And BetterMouse can use the thumb wheel as a button, even though it's not one. So you can tap it and assign an action to that, or tap it and hold it and also assign an action to that. The thing is that with this app, you got some hacks that I haven't seen anywhere else. And I'm just scratching the surface here because there's so many more gestures or button combinations. SteerMouse, on the other hand, implements something that is called chording. And chording is when you press and hold a button and at the same time press a second button. And that's what will generate the action. So maybe in BetterMouse, I was pressing the thumb wheel and then moving the entire mouse to one side or the other one to move between spaces. And here you can do that by pressing the thumb wheel, holding it, and then pressing this one to jump to one, or pressing this other button to jump to other one. I think this is perhaps the biggest difference between the features of both apps. It all comes down to whether you prefer gestures or chords. I have to say that while chording sounds pretty cool, you can actually replicate some of this by using BetterTouchTool or something more advanced like Carabiner. You can use any of these two apps that work without issues together with BetterMouse. And here is where things start to get interesting and maybe a little bit technical, but stay with me. I will try to explain this in a simple way. Let's say that this is a user up here, and this is the user's system with his keyboard and his mouse. Down here, we have different applications like a note-taking app, a calendar, mail app, a browser, to-do list, reminders. What normally happens is that the user will press something on his keyboard and something will happen in one of these applications. Maybe he will click somewhere and a menu will open, or open a file and do something with it. Sometimes the user will repeat actions again and again. First, he will go to his mail, he will copy something, he will paste it on his note-taking app. Or sometimes he will just do the same actions in one app again and again and again. So somebody had the brilliant idea of coming up with automation. And with automation, what happens is that we have this other layer up here of applications like BetterTouchTool, like BetterMouse, Alfred, Raycast, SteerMouse. And with this, the user not only can send actions like before directly to the other apps, but he can trigger one single action here. And this one will take care of performing multiple actions across different apps or specific actions in one of them. This is me trying to explain what automation is all about. Now, the interesting thing here, and something that you have to pay attention, is that all of these apps that are automation related, they have different triggers, which is what are they listening from the user to then perform different actions. In something like BetterTouchTool, for example, we have different kinds of triggers like magic mouse gestures, trackpad gestures, some clicks from normal mice if they are supported, and we also have keyboard shortcuts. Keyboard shortcuts are actually one of the most common triggers, not only in automation apps, but in many other applications. So here we can say, you know, when the user presses Command R, I wanted to perform one of these very useful actions. The interesting thing here is that most of these apps can also simulate key presses. So here, for example, I can say when the user presses Command R, I want him to send a Command Option G to all of these other apps. This is actually what we were seeing before in BetterMouse that I showed you. I have all of these different keyboard shortcuts. Now, why am I telling you this? All of these automation apps, they will have different kinds of triggers. And that's why it's useful to have more than one. Because, for example, BetterTouchTool cannot listen to all the clicks from my mouse, but BetterMouse can do that. Now, if BetterMouse can listen to this, but the actions inside BetterMouse are too limited for me, what I want to do is, of course, use BetterMouse to trigger an action inside BetterTouchTool. How can I do it? BetterMouse can send key events, like I showed you. But the thing to consider here is that the system gives different priority to all of these different processes. So if one application of automation is higher in priority, it can, without issue, send key events to the ones that are in lower priority. But the other way around is not possible. All of this to say that with BetterMouse, I can send key events that will be recognized in Keyboard Maestro, but not in BetterTouchTool. On the other hand, SteerMouse can send key events that will be recognized in BetterTouchTool, but not in Keyboard Maestro. If you start to get into automation, very soon you will realize that the best way to have all of these different automation applications to communicate between one another is by using Apple Script or URL schemes. With this, you do not have to worry about them having different priority on your system. Unfortunately, these two apps, BetterMouse and SteerMouse, do not offer Apple Script support or opening URLs. This is actually quite limiting because if you have some actions in BetterTouchTool that you cannot live without, like hiding notifications or something related to window management, then the only way to trigger that from BetterMouse would be to simulate a keyboard shortcut that Keyboard Maestro will recognize as an event. Then this will trigger a macro, then use this to trigger an Apple Script that will finally trigger an action in BetterTouchTool. Alfred also recognizes key events from BetterMouse, so you could also go that route. The thing is that you just have to start chaining things like this to get what you need. In my personal use case, since I found that BetterMouse key events were recognized by Keyboard Maestro, I decided to make it a goal to use this app for most of my mouse automations. BetterMouse, by the way, also allows you to set up different actions to the same button or gesture in different applications. So in something like your note-taking app, a gesture can make a new note, and the same gesture can open up a new tab on your browser, for example. I want to go back to BetterTouchTool for just one moment. Here is where you can set some of those chords that you have in SteerMouse, but you do not have in BetterMouse. And to do that, you would go to the normal mouse section. Of course, I have to mention that with BetterTouchTool, you are a little bit more limited because not all of the buttons of your mouse may be recognized. In my case, it recognizes the left, the right, the middle one, and two buttons on the side. And that's enough for me, really. Let's say that I start a new action. And one thing to note here is that the button that you set here will not be the one that starts the chord, but the one that ends it. So let's say I want to end this chord with the button 4, which is one of the side ones. I will go to advanced, then advanced conditions, and I only need one condition. We got all of this list of different conditions that we can set. What I'm looking for is currently pressed mouse buttons, and then contains. And then if you want to find out what's the ID of the mouse button that will start the chord, you can just press it. And here on this window on the side, you can see. So in my case is number 2. So I will press here, number 2, save. Let's assign a very random action, just Command E. And I will show the HUD just to see that it's working. So in that case, remember, you will start your chord with the one that you set in the condition, which is my middle button. And then the second button is my side button. There it is. It's working. So that's a chord for you. I will still give you a link in the description of the video where it can explain a little bit more in their forum. I do not have many actions set up like this. I have one to close all my browser windows without closing my browser itself, one to dismiss notifications, and I have one chord for Dropover, an app that I talked about before, which gives you temporary shelves. When I press my left mouse button and then the right one on top of that, my mouse will grab whatever is inside the Dropover shelf and drag it to my mouse position. I don't have to worry about BetterMouse messing with any of these chords here because BetterTouchTool has higher priority. So whatever I set up here will kick in before the events are recognized by BetterMouse. I know that I'm giving you lots of information and ideas, and probably you think that maybe this is enough. I actually thought the same, but just when I thought that I had everything about my mouse setup figured out, I discovered Kando, and wow. This app is absolutely incredible. Kando is a circular menu that pops up exactly where your cursor is. This is not the only app of this type, but I have tested many and I haven't found any other as powerful as this. Once you open one of Kando's menus, and I have this assigned to my mouse buttons, by the way, you have all of these icons around and you can click one of them to go inside the submenu or to perform an action. And again, you have all of these icons that again can perform actions or go inside different submenus. Let me go inside the configuration to show you around. Everything here is very, very customizable. Let me start a new menu just to show you some of the actions. So you can run commands, you can simulate hotkeys, simulate macros. You can, of course, add as many submenus as you want. And again, here you can add more of these actions. You can paste text. You can open URLs. So while we have fewer actions compared to some of the other automation apps that I have been showing you around, the ones that we have here are extremely, extremely powerful because they allow you to communicate with other automation apps with zero issues. One thing that I wanted to highlight is that even though with Kando you can have so many menus and submenus and so many different actions, you do not actually have to sacrifice speed, because if you can remember the path to one of your most used actions, for example, this one that hides my front app, let me open there. You can simply drag and release and have it perform that action in like half a second. For example, I have this other one that I use all the time to open my workflow for Super Whisper, and it's like a triangle, so I can just do that very fast. So it's fast, intuitive, and super powerful. I've used this in some videos, and every time I receive messages or emails asking me about it, you can really do so much with Kando. I use it for activating apps, hiding or closing windows, controlling dropover, controlling CleanShot for annotation. I use it to control Clop for image or video optimization, for running Alfred workflows, for running Keyboard Maestro macros, for text transformations, for opening folders, opening websites. I use it to control Yabai for window management and so much more. Kando is actually cross-platform, so it works on Mac, on Linux, on Windows, and this makes it, of course, absolutely incredible. With all of these applications that I have been telling you about, you can do so much. You can set up your system in a way that is super intuitive, something that allows you to perform so many different actions with gestures and combinations of buttons or modifiers. Basically, all of those things that you find yourself doing again and again, clicking specific menus, opening specific apps, moving around files, a lot of it you can easily automate. But still, something that I have come to realize is that some of the things that I use all the time are some of the most basic. So I still suggest that you assign some buttons to stuff like Command-Z, copy, paste, press return, escape, backspace. All of these will allow you to close or accept system dialogues, take a quick look at files, select text to copy or delete it, and so much more. I know that this might seem like a lot, but you do not have to implement everything at once. You can start with some of the basics that I mentioned. I will give you a link in the description with the actions that I currently have set for BetterMouse, just to give you some ideas. But remember, this is about finding what works best for you. Your workflow is unique, and that's the beauty of all of these tools. They are completely customizable to how you work. If you would like to know something specific about any of these apps, or if you would like me to make a video diving deeper into any of them, I will be very happy to listen to suggestions. The same, let me know if you want to see something specific about my setup. Remember that you can always sign up for my newsletter for weekly updates on whatever I'm working on, content that I consume, discoveries, things that I'm learning, or films that I recommend. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and I'll talk to you soon.